Gary Hall Sr. If I told you 16 years ago that you'd won 11 WA Pacing Cups in the space of 16 years and you're going for 12 Pacing Cups, what would you say?
I'd say you'd probably lost your marbles, Ken. But I it's just unbelievable to me. I can't believe it, because the Pacing Cup is our best race, and I always wanted to win it, and it was one of my dreams to win it, and to have won it 11 times now, and going for 12 is to me, I'm very proud of that fact.
You're going to try and win the Pacing Cup 8 years in a row. That's phenomenal. No other trainer of any code in the world has ever won the same race 8 years in a row.
Yeah, I haven't yet either, Ken. I have won seven, so it's something that I have to pinch myself to come to the terms with it. I just can't imagine ever doing that. And I've been very lucky with a lot of very good owners and some very good horses, but there's been a lot of hard work involved in getting there too.
Now, Gary, you've got three runners this year. You've had five a couple of times in the Pacing Cup. You've got the Chicago Bull, a Hoka Punter, American Boy, and My Hard Copy makes four. So My Hard Copy's won the Fremantle Cup. He's won two WA Pacing Cups. And My Hard Copy's drawn the inside of the back line. Chicago Bull's drawn the outside of the front line.
Yeah, it's. I would have rather... If they were going to draw 9 and 10, that's the way I'd like it. Obviously, Hard Copy's a lot better suited to sit and sprint, and he's going to have that chance. There's going to be a lot of action on and running, I think. I don't think it's going to be for the faint-hearted. This race is you can look at it and come up with three or four different leaders. And obviously, so Tribeca's going to make an early move, and I would imagine he won't make the same mistake as he made last year. He'll stay in front of Chicago Bull at all costs. So, it's going to be a great race, and I'm still got a leaning towards Chicago Bull, although Hard Copy is very lethal when he's held up for one run. So that's the way I look at it.
And like My Hard Copy, he's come back in this preparation in fabulous form. First up win, and then the Village Kid sprint. He didn't get a clear run, and then he's won the Fremantle Cup.
Yeah, no, he's come back great. Yeah, he's come back. He probably should have won all three back from a spell, really. The Village Kid sprint, if he'd have got clear, he would have won as well. And he's going great, and he's got a little bit more point-to-point speed than Chicago Bull, I would say. Just tactically, he's just got that little bit more if they go really hard. So, and I'm sure Bully's going to have to go early at some stage and make sure that Tribeca doesn't get it all his own way up near the leaders. So it's going to be a great tactical race to watch.
See, last Friday night, it was an interesting tactical race in the Fremantle Cup, and Gary Jr. Drove an aggressive race to keep the breeze, and his was a phenomenal run by Chicago Bull. Surely to run third in that race behind My Hard Copy, it was an outstanding performance by Chicago Bull. Was it his best run ever, even though he's won a lot of Group 1 events?
You'd have to say it probably was his best run ever, Ken. Yeah, he did go phenomenal. I thought his race winning last year's Pacing Cup was pretty good. But I would say it's probably one of his best runs ever, and he deserves to be favourite for this race, even from barrier 9. And he's in form, I believe myself. I might be wrong, but I hope I'm not. I believe that he'll probably strip a little bit fitter this week than he was last week in the Fremantle Cup, because he didn't do enough work in the Village Kid sprint, and he got held up and never got clear till late. And I just think he, probably needed the run slightly Friday night, and I think this Friday night you'll see that, he'll go as good as he can go.
Talking about your number three and number four runners in Hoka Punter, who's drawn the back line, the outside of the back, and also American Boy, who's drawn four, and he was a good winner, did a bit of work before he won last Friday night, American Boy. What sort of chance do you give him in this race?
I would have given him a lot better chance if he'd drawn to lead or take a sit close to the lead. Without doing a lot of work, but from there he's going to have to do a little bit. So, I'd be a bit worried about his chances, but he is a strong stayer. And there's a few handover horses there, like Bucket List and that, and he might be able to get forward. He's a quick beginner, so we'll go forward. Galactic Scar might lead. We'll try and push forward and get a forward position with him. And, he's got some hope to be in the money, yeah.
And Hoka Punter, he'll probably be a 100-1 chance from the outside of the back line.
Yeah, he probably doesn't deserve to be 100-1. He's working not too bad at all. And his run the other night wasn't bad, and he's running the Village Kid sprint. He never got a clear run. So, I wouldn't completely write him off. He could be a long shot winning chance there. Yeah, he's definitely got the ability, but the Barry draw has hurt him.
How are you going to sleep this week before the Pacing Cup on Friday night, coming up for your eighth successive Pacing Cup win?
I'll sleep the same, Ken. I don't sleep that well anyway at the best of times, but I won't be thinking too much about it. I don't have to drive them anymore.
Thanks very much for your time, Gary.
Thanks, Ken.